Hello, everybody, and welcome. We've got a full house of cheering fans, including Earl B., the home team's biggest fan.
Earl B., Earl B., he's a man. Earl B., Earl B., the home team's biggest fan.
Great day, great game. Thanks to all you fans for coming out, especially Earl B. See you next game, everybody.
For all of your sports in Lorain, keep your TV tuned to TV 20, Lorain City Schools Television.
Good afternoon, basketball fans from Lorain Admiral King High School inside the Shot Palace. I'm Ron Bacalar, along with my partner Bob Braskich, our cameraman, producer, and director Joe Bach. And we've got a whole afternoon and evening of basketball. The Lorain Admiral King Lady Admirals playing host to the Lorain Southview Lady Saints, and we begin with the freshman game. The Admiral King freshmen, coached by Angie Thomas, are 2-10 on the season. The Lady Saints freshmen, coached by Bernie Bogan, are 9-6 on the season. And we're just about ready to get this game underway. Bob, any thoughts?
Well, my thoughts aren't about the game, but about freshman basketball. What we're looking for tonight is, you know, improvement as far as the fundamentals of the game are concerned. And then most importantly, at the freshman level, other than the fundamentals, we want the kids to get hooked on the game so they stick with it.
And I'm sure you're going to catch just exactly what they're doing right and what they need to work on as far as improvement for the years to come.
Right.
All right, we'll be back with the start of the game right after this brief timeout.
Cece's Pizza, all you can eat for only $3.99.
Cece's Buffet has 16 kinds of great-tasting pizza, pasta, salad, and desserts, all you can eat for only $3.99. And Cece's was voted number one for overall customer satisfaction.
Best buffet that you can find, lunch and dinner anytime. Let's go to Cece's Pizza. Great taste at a great price.
All right, ready to roll, and the jump center, the ball in the hands of the Lady Saints. This is a freshman game. Starting for the Saints, number 20, Marissa Elliott. Number 22, Sierra Sanchez. Number 24 is Myra Ramos. Number 40 is Demetria Lee. And number 52 is Sharday Thorpe. And right away, we have a foul. Or a turnover.
That may have been a three-second call, Ron.
All right, three-second call. That's a turnover. Lady Admirals have it.
Up
with the shot and missing is Kiera Lagarde.
And a travel call in the key on that stick back.
Starting for the Lady Admirals, number 11 is Kiera Lagarde, a 5'7". These are all freshmen. Number 14 is Dominique Starr, 5'5". And a two-point shot put up and missed by Myra Ramos. Here come the Lady Admirals. Taja Myrick, number 22 for the Admirals, 5'4". Number 31 is Latasha Kimbrough, 5'4". And number 54 is Monica Cortez, 5'7". Those are the starting players for the Lady Saints and the Lady Admirals. And a takeaway by the Admirals. To the basket, up and missing is Latasha Kimbrough.
Ron, one of the things I like so far, and I think it's very important at the freshman level, boys or girls, to play man-to-man defense. And both teams are doing that. I don't think at this level you learn to play if you pack a zone back in, and I'm glad to see both teams trying to play man-to-man.
Or lady-to-lady.
There you go. There you go. You know, and the other thing we look for is good choices. And we always say during the broadcast, make the easy pass. And that's never more appropriate than it is at the freshman level.
That is going to be off the foot and into the backcourt, over and back. So the turnover gives the ball to the Lady Saints.
Right, so many turnovers at this level are self-inflicted wounds from forcing the basketball and not recognizing, you know, what's a doable situation, so to speak. Make the easy pass.
Making the shot for the Lady Saints, Sierra Sanchez, missing, but she's fouled. And she'll go to the line to shoot two.
And one of the things I'd like both teams to do, just watching and observing the first two minute or so, is, gals, you have to be ready. In the dead ball situation, you have to be ready. And I see, oh, nice shot. I see that both teams, neither are ready to play. And consequently, you know, in those dead balls, you have to be broken down. You have to be picked up. You have to be organized.
In the lineup now for the Lady Admirals, number 20 is Alicia Bradford, 5'8". And Sierra Sanchez making both foul shots. So the Lady Saints on the board first. It's 2-0. And a reaching foul is going to be called on Alicia Bradford, or make that Marissa Elliott. Her first, the team's first.
Okay.
Up and in for Latasha Kimbrough, tying up the score at 2-2 with 5 minutes remaining in the first quarter.
You know, that happened because there was good spacing. The floor was spread.
Loose ball out of bounds, last touched by Sierra Sanchez. Lady Admirals will get it.
Well, so many times at the lower levels and at the varsity, too, for that matter, there isn't good spacing on offense, and consequently, you defense yourself.
Full court pressure being put on by the Lady Saints. Loose ball picked up by Demetria Lee into the lane, and she's going to be called for traveling.
A traveling call at the lower levels for girls is probably the most common, the most common call there is. And you have to work at that in practice. There are a lot of drills to pass, catch, and square up.
To the basket, okay. Dropping in 2 points, Dominique Starr. The Lady Admirals take a 4-2 advantage. Missed shot by Sierra Sanchez. Rebound by Alicia Bradford.
Well, thus far, the passing and catching of the game has been very good.
Oh, and a nice pass and a missed shot by Latasha Kimbrough.
Uh-oh, here we go.
We're going to have a jump ball, and the possession arrow belongs to King, so Lady Admirals will put it into play.
Okay, now, defensively, gals should all be picked up, broken down, ready to play. That's a block. Okay, you know, again, we talk about spacing. Three offensive players just all mingling around the 10-second line, you know, creating congestion, defending themselves. You have to spread the floor.
Foul is on Sierra Sanchez, her first, the team's second. And a takeaway by Sanchez, and she's going to be called for traveling.
That's okay. She had the right idea. Sanchez was going to come to a big jump stop and put the ball softly off the glass. She had the right idea.
Now, see, there's a reach over.
Yeah, and it might get called. And, Ron, that might have been like a warning.
Okay.
Which is, I've never heard of before.
I know in the boys' game that we covered, there were no warnings. Right. There was right away technicals, unless the fact that these are freshmen and they're still learning the rules, let alone the game.
And I like that when an official does exactly what you're suggesting at the freshman level. Explain the situation, explain the rule as opposed to blowing the whistle.
Foul is on Shardae Thorpe, her first, and the team's third. At the line to shoot two, Dominique Starr. By the way, Dominique Starr, number 14, 5'5", she is on Pam Jackson's varsity list for the tournaments. So she's going to be dressed for the tournaments.
Very good, right off the glass, banks are open. Okay. First open gal should get the ball.
Out of bounds, it will belong to Admiral King.
That was either a step over the line run or a 5 second call, and that was pretty well done. The play was well designed.
I do believe it was a step over the line. Five to two is our score. Lady Admirals leading by three. Sanchez across the court, passing to Thorpe. Thorpe up with it, no good off the rim. Going out of bounds, it will belong to the Saints. We're down to 2 minutes and 58 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Underneath the basket in the lane, and we have a foul.
Okay, that goes back to those dead ball situations. When the ball's out of bounds, you have to be broken down and see the ball, gals. Everybody right now defensively on the goal team or the King team should be broken down, find your people, and see the basketball.
Foul was on Latasha Kimbrough, her first, the team's second.
You know, and one of the other things I always look for with freshmen is, how is your stance? How's your footwork?
We've got some substitutions we'll talk about. Number four in the lineup now, Alicia Williams for Admiral King, 5 foot two.
Wow, that was a close one. Freshman girls, you have to overlook that once in a while.
Also in the lineup for the Admirals, Asia Lusane, 5 foot four, number 30. Number 52 is Natasha Randleman, 5 foot eight. And Natasha, as well as Dominique Snar that we talked about, is also on Pam Jackson's varsity list for the tournaments, which will be held at Westlake.
Okay.
Off the front of the rim on the shot by Sharday Thorpe. Ball fought for, jump ball, arrow belongs to the Saints. We're still at 5-2, Lady Admirals leading by three, and now their lead is down to just one on that shot by Sierra Sanchez.
And that goes back to kind of my mantra for the game, which is you have to be ready to play on those dead ball situations. The King gals weren't picked up, the Southview gals stepped right to the ball and scored.
We have a foul against one of the Lady Saints. That's the fourth team foul. Shot missed by Randleman.
Stick back, number four for the Admirals.
That is Alicia Williams. And a takeaway. Randleman grabbing it. Shot put up and missed by Kiera Lagarde.
You know, the other thing I like that both teams are doing is the girls are trying to use the glass.
And another takeaway by Randleman, and the ball fought for, jump ball. Possession arrow belongs to King. Seven, four, Lady Admirals leading by three. All 4 points for Southview, by the way, scored by Sierra Sanchez. Two foul shots and a field goal.
Pass the basketball.
Across the timeline in time. Underneath the basket, Randleman up, hits the backboard, no good. Rebound being fought for, ball still rolling, and finally, Dominique Starr. 3 seconds in the lane.
One of the things I like about Randleman, Ron, is, and I don't have her height, she looks to be about 5'10 or so.
5'8 is what we were told.
And she's the tallest gal on the floor, but she runs up and down the floor very well, and I'm impressed with how aggressive she is rebounding the basketball. Her skill level will come.
A takeaway, ball grabbed by Kiera Lagarde.
Nice pass. Oh!
Shot put up by Lagarde and missed. Out of bounds, King will keep possession. We're under a minute, 59 seconds remaining, 7-4, Lady Admirals by three.
If they run the same little play here, they're going to go set a pick on the post person, reverse pivot. There it is.
And the ball getting away from Pierre Lagarde out of bounds, so Southview will put it into play. All that took just 1 second.
You know, and both teams are picking up. I like that also.
Another traveling call on the Lady Saints.
They're picking up and they're trying to defense the full court, and I think that's good. That's smart in girls basketball.
Monica Cortez back in the lineup for the Lady Admirals. Kiara Lagarde will get a breather. Take away by the Lady Saints, Marissa Elliott. Up the floor to Sanchez, missing on the shot.
Oh.
Back to Elliott, no good, and it is Randleman who finally comes down with it for the Lady Admirals.
Oh, no call there. And we have a player down. Well, the official in that situation did the right thing, stopped play.
Coach Bogan would like to have had a charging call against the Lady Admirals, but the official didn't see it that way.
That's Sharday Thorpe for the Saints. I think she's okay.
Kind of banged the back of her head as she
right.
hit the court. Pass in to Williams, missing on the shot. And the ball going out of bounds. Last touch by the Lady Saints. So the Admirals will keep it with 27 and a half seconds remaining.
All right, I'm going to keep saying it until it happens right. You have to be ready to play. And on that dead ball situation, the girls weren't picked up again. Okay.
Pass to Cortez. Up with the ball. No good. Coming down with the rebound, Myra Ramos. Long pass down the court. Finally, the Lady Saints get it. Up and missing on the shot, Elliott. Sanchez.
Oh!
No good. Sanchez gets the ball back again.
7 seconds, 6-5. Clock situation, gals.
They're not going to get the shot off.
Oh.
And that ends the first quarter with the score. The Lady Admirals, 7. And the Lady Saints 4 in this freshman encounter here at the Shot Palace. Back with the second quarter right after this.
Your one-stop place for something really special is Impressions, corner of Oberlin Avenue and Tower Boulevard. T-shirts and sweatshirts personally designed to your specific needs. Anything from bears, trains to zebras, and specially designed hats as well. And don't forget Impressions, your one-stop spot for school jackets. See Dave, the designer expert at Impressions, Oberlin Avenue at Tower Boulevard, right here in Lorain.
Second quarter action getting underway here at the Shot Palace. Lady Admirals leading the Lady Saints 7-4 in this freshman encounter. They are playing, and a traveling call on Felicia Franklin, now in the lineup for the Lady Saints. Felicia Franklin, number 12, 5'3". And another whistle.
Over the line. These officials are doing a fine job. I would kind of be a little bit lenient in my interpretation of traveling at this level with the gals.
Well, whatever happened down there, the ball came off the legs of Monica Cortez, but somehow the Lady Admirals were able to put it into play. The official gave an explanation to Bernie Bogan, the Southview coach, but we could not hear it from up here. And a foul is going to be called against the Lady Admirals. The foul is on Monica Cortez, a blocking foul. That's her first and the team's third.
Powered up.
Up and missing on the shot by Sharday Thorpe. Gets her own rebound, puts it up, and it's in.
3-point opportunity.
Sharday Thorpe with her first 2 points, a chance for a 3-pointer.
You know, Ron, and I think both teams are doing just fine offensively, and I know the girls are going to watch. Gals, remember, don't catch and put the basketball on the floor unless you're taking it to the basket when you're running your offense, or unless you're dribbling to get a better passing angle.
Thorpe making the foul shot.
Well done.
And that ties our score at 7-7.
Every time you catch and dribble the basketball without a purpose, you let the defense set. And that's not what you want to happen.
Taja Myrick back in the lineup for the Lady Admirals. And a takeaway by Sanchez. Gets it to Thorpe, back to Sanchez. Up and in!
Nice stroke.
Sierra Sanchez now with 6 points. Leading scorer in the ball game and puts the Lady Saints ahead for the first time. 9-7, Southview.
Okay,
and a traveling call on Latasha Kimbrough will give the ball back to Southview. Dominique Starr back in the lineup for Admiral King. We were talking during the quarter break that in the days of yore, freshmen played 6 minutes,
right.
JV played 7,
right.
And the varsity played 8. But now they have a choice.
Right.
And we'll talk about that in a moment, putting up the ball and missing Taja Myrick.
Ron, that was number 11 for the Admirals.
All right,
on the stick
Kiara back. Lagarde getting the stick back.
Right, Ron, and I think it's a league rule. The state only would require 6. They'd allow 6, but the Lake Erie League has obviously allowed 7 at the freshman level, which is good.
Thorpe on the shot, no good.
You know, one of the things you like to see at the freshman level is a lot of kids getting some playing time. Of course, you have to earn playing time, but you'd like to see as many kids playing as possible, and that 7 minutes gives you a 28-minute game, a little bit more time.
Sanchez.
Okay, Sanchez
two
can
more.
Score. She is a future scorer, I can see
she's
that.
She's got 8 points already.
Well, she has a nice little release, and she's offensive-minded, and she doesn't pound the ball on the floor with her dribble unnecessarily. She's got a nice soft touch, uses the glass.
Now in the lineup for Southview, number 54 is Latasha Hamilton at 5'6". Randleman saving that one. Knocked out of bounds by Shardae Thorpe.
Okay, gals, when you flash to the perimeter to go get the basketball and you're denied and you don't get it, don't stand. Back cut. Go right to the basket. Or go away and set a pick for a teammate.
Lady Saints, and that's Latasha Hamilton with her first two, and it's now a 4-point advantage for Southview, 13-9, with 4:45 remaining in the second quarter.
Off the glass.
Didn't get quite the right bounce on that shot.
Look up the floor. Oh, good effort.
And that effort by Alicia Bradford. All right, Southview calling a 30-second timeout with 4:32 remaining, and we'll be back right after this.
At 32, Carol had her first heart attack. Michelle began kidney dialysis right before graduation. A brain seizure kept Maria out of work for nearly a year. Without warning, lupus can attack the major organs. Every day, it disables its victims, especially women. Like most Americans, I didn't know how life-threatening lupus could be until my sister was diagnosed. It's time we do something about it.
For more information about lupus, contact the Lupus Foundation of America.
Number 14 for Southview in the lineup now, Lisa Friend, a 5'7" freshman.
Ooh.
Dominique Starr saving that one from going out of bounds, but making the interception is Latasha Hamilton, and coming right back with it is Kiera Lagarde. Correction, Tasia Myrick.
Okay, now I'd like all the girls to be broken down right now. Hand in the passing lane, seeing the basketball.
Up and in on a shot by Dominique Starr. Starr now with 5 points.
We're getting a lot of scores on out-of-bounds plays because, again, we're not ready to play on the dead ball.
Starr again, two more. And that ties up the score at 13-13 with just under 4 minutes remaining. And that one's going to go out of bounds.
Well, Dominique Starr can definitely put the ball on the floor, and that was appropriate to put it on the floor there because she attacked the basket. Okay, we've got people not picked up again.
Sanchez gets it, and a blocking foul is going to be called on Monica Cortez. That's her third. And the team's fifth, the Lady Admirals with 16 fouls, the Lady Saints with 4. Next foul by the Lady Admirals will put the Lady Saints at the line for the bonus 1-1. Almost a takeaway, still a loose ball, finally picked up by Hamilton.
Well, I really like the way the girls are hustling, and I think the girls are playing hard, both teams.
Well, anytime you get Admiral King and Southview playing each other in any sport, it's going to be everyone giving his or her best. Traveling call will give the ball to the Lady Admirals.
Okay, gals, when you catch the ball on the perimeter, pivot on your inside foot and chin the basketball. Make yourself a threat. Don't catch it and put it above your head. That allows the defense to get right into you. You don't want the defense to get into you. Don't catch it and put it above your head.
One of the Lady Saints not dressed for this afternoon's game. Up and in on a shot by Monica Cortez. That's her first 2 points. Sarah Santana. Sarah Santana normally wearing number 32. She's 5'5", but she's got a broken ankle. So Sarah, sorry you can't be with us this afternoon for some basketball action. But we certainly wanted to take the opportunity to recognize your efforts in the season thus far.
That's Miss Starr. She does a nice job handling the basketball. Against full court pressure, I'd throw it to her and get out of her road.
Shot missed by Asia Lusane. And a foul is going to be called. I think it's going to be called against the Lady Admirals. And indeed it is. Alicia Bradford called for her first personal foul. And that's going to put the Lady Saints at the line, shooting 1-1. Looking at some of the Lady Admiral ninth graders, freshman players, Kiera Lagarde. Her favorite class is math, and her favorite teacher is Miss Marquez, is it,
yes,
Bob?
It's Miss Marquez. Very nice new teacher to the district, couple years, very nice gal.
And the shot made by Felicia Franklin. Her first point of the afternoon. Kiera's friends and family have been her biggest influences in her sports career. Tracy McGrady is her favorite professional sports player, and her future goals to make money. Drawing, volleyball, and basketball are her hobbies and interests.
Oop, on the line.
She has a 3.5 GPA.
Wow.
She's received sports and academic honors, volleyball, merit roll, basketball.
That's great.
The family history has people playing baseball, basketball, track, cross country, wrestling, and football. So she comes, without a doubt, from a sports family. That's Kiara Lagarde for the Lady Admirals. Kiara wears number 11.
And there's a gal there, Dominique Starr, number 14. You know, we've been talking about when it's appropriate to dribble the basketball, and when she puts it on the floor, she attacks. And that is, again, you're going to attack the basket or you're going to dribble, get a better passing angle. Other than that, the ball should be passed. She does a nice job.
Dominique fouled while she was in the act of shooting. Misses the first foul shot, as she did the last time she was at the line, then made the second, so we'll see if there's a repeat performance.
Okay, she needs a little bit more lift on her shot, a little bit more arc on her shot. The rim gets larger the more arc you have.
And it does not drop, but Kiara Lagarde gets the rebound. And the ball going out of bounds, Southview will put it into play.
You know, Ron, I remember playing as a youngster, and a coach told me one time, if you do it right, you can get two basketballs to through the rim at the same time, and that's true, but you have to have lift on your shot and let it fall through vertically to allow that to happen. That's why lift and arc on the shot is so important, and I keep saying, well, the rim gets larger, you can actually fit two balls through the rim at the same time.
Foul is on Dominique Starr, and Latasha Hamilton at the line. She'll shoot 1-1. One of the other Lady Admiral freshmen is Tasia Munich.
Oh.
We would like to recognize Tasia Myrick. I'm sorry, Tasia Myrick. Her favorite class is math, and Ms. Boyle is her favorite teacher. Hamilton making both foul shots. And we've got a one-point advantage by the Lady Saints. 16-15 is our score.
You know, and Tasha had nice lift on her shot, a nice soft shot. Good rotation, good backspin, good release.
Tasia Myrick's favorite interest and hobby is to chill. And I don't think that means to get cold.
No,
just to kind of
means to relax.
Relax, eh? Absolutely.
I'm into that too. The older I get, the more I'm into chilling.
I've been there for some time. 3.5 is Tasia's GPA. So we salute Tasia Myrick. Latasha Kimbrough from Lorain Admiral King, a freshman. Her favorite class is also math. My golly, these freshman gals are enjoying math. Her favorite teacher, Mrs. Velez. And she likes Mrs. Velez because she teaches in a way that the students can understand and they don't have to struggle.
Shoot it.
Shot put up and missed by Alicia Williams.
Oh.
3-second violation. That'll give the ball to the Lady Saints with a minute and 38 remaining. Latasha Kimbrough's influence in her sports career has been her uncle and cousins. Tracy McGrady is her favorite professional sports player, as well as Kobe Bryant. She intends to go to college and make money. Basketball, softball, and drums, her interests and hobbies, and she carries a 3.5 GPA. She's been on the honor roll, and the family has been involved in basketball and football.
You know, Ron, I'm surprised to hear in more of the bios, we aren't hearing LeBron James. It's always Tracy McGrady and Kobe Bryant. I'm very surprised.
Now that you bring that up, you're right.
Oh, nice stroke.
Shot missed by Hamilton. Dominique Starr got the pass, and she was fouled immediately. And the foul is going to be on Lisa Friend, her first, and the team's seventh. So that is going to put Dominique at the line to shoot the bonus 1-1.
You know, I'd also like to commend the players. I see a lot of smiles on the place, on the floor. The girls are having a good time. They listen to their coaches very well. I pay special attention to things like, you know, what are they doing during a timeout? Are they all attentive, standing around the coach? And I'm seeing that tonight, and that's all good.
Oh, a good hard foul shot put up and made by Dominique Starr.
Let's see if she goes for that again, and let's see if that was an accident. No, she's going for it.
Well, the first foul shot made tied the score at 16-16, and Kiara Lagarde came down with a rebound, and we're going to have a jump ball as Alicia Williams and one of the Lady Saints grabbed it simultaneously. Natasha Randleman now back in the lineup for the Lady Admirals, giving Alicia Bradford a breather. 1 minute, 11 seconds. We're in the second quarter, tied up at 16-16.
Okay.
Dribbling the baseline, but stepping on it the Lady Admirals, Latasha Kimbrough.
We see the boys do that too. I'll tell you, I don't know about dribbling it down there on that baseline like that. That's no man's land. Get it off the baseline. Get the ball reversed. Don't defend yourself.
Ooh. Whoa, and a push. The foul will be on Latasha Hamilton. And that is going to put Latasha Kimbrough at the line. She'll shoot 1-1. Both teams now with 8 personal fouls with 59 seconds remaining. Real quick, want to talk about big number 52, Natasha Randleman. Health and Human Services with Mrs. McGill, or Ms. McGill is her favorite class and teacher. She finds it very interesting. Her family has been her biggest influence in her sports career. Lisa Leslie is her favorite professional sports player. Her future goals, to graduate. She loves to talk on the telephone and go traveling. And Natasha Randleman with a 3.5 GPA.
Nice stroke there by Latasha Kimbrough. Very nice release and stroke.
Making both foul shots, and that gives the Lady Admirals a 2-point advantage, 18-16.
Now that should have been a blocking call, but the little ones they call and the big ones that I think should get called don't get called. And I see Miss Starr limping around on a slightly twisted ankle. Number 4, Ryan.
Basket made by Alicia Williams. That's her second field goal. And a takeaway, Dominique Starr. And a traveling ball
okay.
on Tierra
right.
Lagarde.
She's got a big smile on her face. The girls are having a good time.
Yeah.
They're having a good time. Both teams, smiling faces. I like the way they clap hands on substitutions.
And a traveling call against the Lady Saints. King gets the ball with 35 seconds remaining. They have a 4-point advantage, 20-16. We are in the second quarter of this freshman encounter. The Lady Admirals playing host to the Lady Saints here in the Shot Palace at Lorain Admiral King High School. Pass to Randleman. Randleman is going to be called for traveling.
You need a middle person against the pressure.
Thor passes the ball up to the front forecourt. It's in Hamilton's hands, and she'll get called for traveling.
14 seconds remaining in the half. Okay, some of that, gals, is because you're taking it one dribble too far. Don't take the ball one dribble too far. Shoot it.
A takeaway by Hamilton, throws the ball into the forecourt, goes out of bounds, so Admiral King will get it.
Okay, 10 seconds. I'm not sure if anybody's aware of the clock situation.
I believe we're going to have a foul called, and I think it's going to be against one of the Lady Admirals. Correction, it's going to be on Shardae Thorpe, her second. The team's ninth. At the line, Alicia Williams for the Lady Admirals. Alicia Williams, a freshman, math with Mrs. Boyle is her favorite class and subject because she makes it so actually good. She can understand math, and it's fun to have a good teacher, says Alicia Williams. The influence in her sports career, her dad, mom, uncle, Mark, her church, and her friends.
Great.
Her favorite professional sports player, Mike Bibby of the Sacramento Kings. She intends to attend college and wants to major in medicine to become a surgeon. Bless her heart.
Okay, now if you're King here, you don't want to foul. 5.9 seconds left.
Oops. Real quick, finishing up on Alicia Williams. After she attends college, she wants to major in medicine to become a surgeon. Her hobbies and interests, sports, singing, shopping, reading, and hairstyling. She has a 4.5
wow.
GPA on the accelerated level.
Wow.
So, and she comes from a real fine sports background. Her uncle Mark was involved in track, basketball, football. Her uncle Greg went to college on a football scholarship. That's Alicia Williams. So the score at the end of the first half, 22 for the Lady Admirals, 16 for the Lady Saints. Bob and I will be back with the second half right after this timeout.
Since 1921, your hometown financial professionals at First Federal Savings of Lorain have dedicated themselves to meeting the financial needs of their customers and surrounding communities. They offer a wide variety of financial investments as well as home mortgages to meet your every need. Loans on boats, cars, mobile homes, and other worthwhile purchases are also available. Whatever your financial need, First Federal Savings of Lorain is ready to help. 7 convenient locations to serve you in Lorain, Huron, Sandusky, Port Clinton, and now at 36690 Detroit Road in Avon. First Federal Savings of Lorain is an equal housing lender and FDIC insured.
Second half action, possession arrow belonging to the Lady Saints, and we're underway here at the Shot Palace, and right away a foul. A reaching foul on the Lady Admirals, Latasha Kimbrough. That's her second and the team's first here in the second half.
Okay.
And a traveling call against the Lady Saints. They trail in the ball game by 6 points. It's 22-16. Admiral King in the lead.
Now we'll have less fouls this half, Ron, because and less travel calls because Southview has taken their press off. They've fallen back into a 2-3 zone. And the Lady Admirals recognized it immediately.
Up with the shot and missing is Monica Cortez. Lady Admirals get the ball back. Up and missing on the shot, Asia Lusane. Pass to Hamilton, missing on the shot, loose ball, and it goes out of bounds. Last touched by the Lady Admirals, so Southview will put it into play.
Okay, gals, we've had two situations, one at either end, high off the glass with the basketball. On your layups, high off the glass.
And a takeaway by the Lady Admirals. Grabbing the ball is Monica Cortez. Here comes Dominique Starr, passing off and putting it up in a foul underneath the basket. That was Latasha Kimbrough on the shot. Foul is on Lisa Friend, her second, and Southview's first. And it's going to put Latasha Kimbrough at the line to shoot two as she was fouled in the act of shooting.
You know, I hate to point anybody out, but I'm very impressed with Dominique Starr. She can bring the basketball against pressure, and she plays very unselfishly. Very unselfishly. I can see point guard written all over her.
Felicia Franklin back in the lineup now for Southview. Looking at the scoring in the first half, Lady Admirals had a 7-4 three-point advantage at the end of the first quarter. In the second quarter, Lady Admirals scored 15 points, Lady Saints 12 points, and our locker room score 22-16, and that's what it is right at the present moment with 5 minutes and 20 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Scoring for Southview, Felicia Franklin had 1 point, Latasha Hamilton had 4 points, Shardae Thorpe had 3, and high for the Lady Saints in the first half was Sierra Sanchez with 8 points. 3 field goals and 2 shots from the foul line. Scoring for the Lady Admirals, Alicia Williams had 6, Kiara Lagarde had 2, Latasha Kimbrough had 4, Monica Cortez had 2, And high for the Lady Admirals, Dominique Starr with 8.
And that was a 5-second call. Again, do not put the basketball above your head, gals. Especially when you have your dribble. Oops.
And we're going to have a foul called on Aisha Lusane.
You know, Ron, we talk a lot about reversing the basketball at the boys' level when we see zones, you know, shifting it from one side of the floor to the other. You have to do that in your man-to-man offense, too. And one of the things the Lady Saints are doing is they're insisting on attacking this corner down here, which is going to get not going to get you where you want to go.
We mentioned the name of Aisha Lusane moments ago. Her favorite teacher is Mr. Knowles. She likes Mr. Knowles because he's nice and easy to understand.
And he's from England, by the way, Ron, with a great British accent.
I love it. I used to teach English literature, senior honors English at Admiral King, and I took a group of students and some adults to England.
I remember that.
Over spring break back in 1984. And I'll tell you, I loved
I remember
every
that.
Moment we spent in England. What an unbelievable country. Foul shot is called. And our bus driver was from Yorkshire. And they don't come any stronger with accents than those Yorkshire people.
Okay, here we have one of those out of bounds. Now everybody's pretty much picked up. But get off to the ball, ladies. Get off to the ball. There we go again. Not ready to play.
And a traveling call against the Lady Saints. Turnover gives the ball to Admiral King.
All right.
Anyway, Aisha Lusane, her influence of the sports career that she has, her mom and dad, and her coach. Her favorite professional sports player is Alan Anthony. Her future goals, to go to college. Her hobbies and interests, basketball and cheerleading, not to mention softball as well. And we have a jump ball with the possession arrow belonging to Admiral King. Aisha Lusane has a 4-point GPA. She's been on the honor roll. And in her family background, there have been basketball and football players. That is Aisha Lusane.
Okay, now the Lady Saints are packing that zone back in there. And as I said in the first half, I like to see man-to-man at the younger levels.
Shot put up and missed by Kiera Lagarde.
Yeah, that's palm of the basketball. And the reason you see a lot of zones at the girls' level is that they pack it in and, you know, get all the defenders back toward the paint is they're banking on you, you know, you can't shoot the basketball from the perimeter.
We're down to 4 minutes and 3 seconds remaining here in the third quarter. No score yet in the third quarter. So we are still at 22-16. Lady Admirals by 6.
But at this level, you will give up more shots playing a zone than you do man-to-man because you just don't force any turnovers with the zone.
In the lane, back out again, and a traveling call. Want to talk now about Alicia Bradford, Miss McGill, Health and Human Services, her favorite teacher in class. Miss McGill is very nice and up to date. She listens and she gives a lot of respect to the students. And of course, she gets it in return. Kind of like the golden rule, do unto others as you would have them do unto you.
Okay, a little bit too much dribbling here, gals. Get the ball passed, get it moving. Don't dribble and pick it up.
The influences in Alicia Bradford's sports career has been Lisa Leslie, Mrs. Wright, her cousin Nikita, her cousin Latasha, and her mother. Kobe Bryant is her favorite professional sports player. She wants to attend Alabama State, majoring in medicine, and become a physician.
Oh,
in and out
almost.
On a shot by the Lady Saints.
Oh.
She gets her own rebound, and that is Marissa Elliott. And she gets the ball back one more time. Hamilton saving it from going out of bounds, but it's taken away by Myrick. And
no.
Tasia Myrick is called for traveling.
No. Call the obvious ones. But again, gals, I know you're watching at home. Don't dribble the basketball so much. Get it passed. and then spread yourself out a little bit better on offense. Everybody's catching it. The first thing they do is they put it on the floor.
Shot missed by Southview's Sierra Sanchez. Lady Saints have given the ball up and a traveling call. They'll get it right back. Anyway, Alicia Bradford, her hobbies and interests include writing poems, playing basketball, dancing, running track, singing, and learning new things, and the band. So she's a musician as well as an athlete, and a scholar athlete, we might add, since she has a 4.2 GPA on the accelerated level.
Okay. Very good.
She has perfect attendance and has received awards for that. She's received awards for three-on-three activities, honor roll, merit roll, most valuable player in the sixth grade basketball, and poetry awards.
Oh, terrific.
I would love to read some of her poems. So if you're watching us, Alicia Bradford, as a retired English teacher, I would enjoy very much reading your poetry if we can somehow make that possible. Hamilton on the shot, missing, and it's recovered by Demetria Lee. Up and missing on the shot is Felicia Franklin.
Well, I know one thing I would do. Coaching either one of these teams, and one of the things that is helpful to correct this dribbling problem is, at practice, you have to run your offense without putting the ball on the floor. And no shot can be taken until you've passed it seven or eight times. Gives you good movement and recognition, and we don't have all this, you know, catch and plunk it on the floor and pick up your dribble.
Well, we played a little over 5 minutes of basketball here in the third quarter, and we have yet to see a point scored. And a takeaway by Hamilton. She's all alone into the lane.
So much
for that opportunity as she gives up the ball on a double dribble.
That's okay.
Wrapping up on Alicia Bradford, her family history in organized sports. Her cousin played basketball. Her mother, Miranda Bradford, played volleyball. Her cousin, Latasha Bradford, ran track and played basketball. That is Alicia Bradford.
Oh, boy.
And another traveling call. 1 minute, 27 seconds remaining in the third quarter, still 22-16. Will we get a point scored in this third quarter, Bob?
Yeah, I think we will. But those traveling calls, they're borderline. I think you have to let those go. They're borderline. They aren't blatant.
Up and missing on the shot, Demetria Lee. Coming down with the rebound, Marissa Elliott.
You know, on the other hand, the other school of thought would be, well, you call it really tight, and the girls will learn from that how to play properly. I mean, there's two sides of looking at it.
Lady Admirals with four team fouls. Lady Saints with just one. Missed shot by Felicia Franklin. In the lineup, by the way, for the Lady Admirals, we failed to mention, is Sherelle Lucky, number 33. Sherelle Lucky, 5'4".
Oh.
It won't drop, but we've got a foul. And the foul is going to be on Alicia Williams. That's the fifth team foul, and that is going to put Latasha Hamilton at the line. She'll shoot two. And speaking of Sherelle Lucky, the ninth grader, Miss McGill is her favorite teacher because she's nice, she's fun, she's funny, and she makes it real. Kobe Bryant is her favorite professional player. And Kobe Bryant, believe it or not, in case you're watching or listening, Kobe, you have been an influence on Sherelle Lucky's sports career as a basketball player. Hamilton missing the second. And getting the only point scored thus far here in the third quarter with 45 seconds remaining.
Of course, Lakers are in town tonight against the Cavaliers,
Ron. Yes, they are.
Kobe Brown
will not be playing.
Bryant will not be playing. Injured
finger. Yeah, he is injured. Anyway, the future goals for Sherelle Lucky is to be a basketball player. Probably would like to get in the WNBA. And we have a jump ball called. It will belong to Admiral King. Sherelle's hobbies and interests include basketball. She loves to watch football. She enjoys soccer. And she enjoys dancing. She has a 2.8 GPA. That is Sherelle Lucky, number 33. Natasha Randleman, she is fouled and she'll go to the line and shoot two. Lady Saints picking up their second team foul. You know, Lady Admirals with six.
And again, one of the things I've enjoyed about watching the game tonight is how the girls play very unselfishly. Every time I thought somebody should get the ball in a scoring position, you know, similar to that when there was an attempt to get it there. I don't see anybody individualizing, you know, forcing the shot for themselves, and that's good to see.
Oh, boy, that went around and around and around.
Well, there's your point in the third quarter, Ron. We've got 21.8 seconds left.
Well, Latasha Hamilton of Southview got the first one in the third quarter.
You're right.
And Natasha Randleman got the second one for the Lady Admirals. Kind of ironic that they're both Natasha. Or Latasha Hamilton, I'm sorry. Latasha Hamilton, Southview. Natasha Randleman, Admiral King. We're just getting familiar with these players.
There we go, not getting picked up and out of bounds situations again. It's happening over and over again. Gals, you both sides, you have to be ready to play.
Sherelle Lucky on the two-pointer. Hamilton with two.
Drilled it.
Latasha Hamilton. She got 3 points here in the third quarter, the only three for Southview. And the Lady Admirals put in three, two by Sherelle Lucky, one by Natasha Randleman. It's 25-19. We'll be back with the fourth and final quarter right after this.
Since 1921, your hometown financial professionals at First Federal Savings of Lorain have dedicated themselves to meeting the financial needs of their customers and surrounding communities. They offer a wide variety of financial investments, as well as home mortgages to meet your every need. Loans on boats, cars, mobile homes, and other worthwhile purchases are also available. Whatever your financial need, First Federal Savings of Lorain is ready to help. 7 convenient locations to serve you in Lorain, Huron, Sandusky, Port Clinton, and now at 36690 Detroit Road in Avon. First Federal Savings of Lorain is an equal housing lender and FDIC insured.
Fourth and final quarter action underway here at the Shot Palace.
Oh.
And another traveling call. Boy, if we would have had a statistician on our staff,
I would have
loved to been able to find out at this point in time how many traveling violations have been called in this freshman game. Score is 25-19.
Oh, that's my goodness.
The first three-pointer of the ball game, and that is Sherelle Lucky.
Wow.
We won't even say that was a lucky shot. That was all skill. Anyway, that puts the Lady Admirals up by 9 now. It's 28-19.
Oh, they're heating up.
And a two-pointer popped in by Lisa Friend. Dominique Starr saving that one.
Well done.
Passing it to Monica Cortez, who drops in 2 points. And Monica Cortez is the final freshman we want to talk about here for the Lady Admirals. Mrs. Clark is her favorite teacher. The class is English. She says that Mrs. Clark is nice and at least acts like she cares. The influence in her sports career have been her parents, who have always come to her games, and her first coaches. Monica Cortez's favorite professional sports player is David Beckham, Coach Holmes, and Coach Vinsek. Her future goals, to become a vet, a veterinarian, or a homicide detective. Either way, she plans to go to college. her interests and hobbies, soccer, basketball, running, drawing, and writing. And she's one of those accelerated academic students with a 4.5 GPA. That is Monica Cortez. Three-point shot by Thorpe, missing.
Another great pass. That gal can play. I see point guard all over Miss Starr.
Monica Cortez.
Dominique Starr has just made some excellent passes in transition when she has the ball in the middle of the floor. Well done. The one thing I noticed she needs work on is if you're going to be a point guard, you have to be back on defense. Both teams, point guards, you're back unless the coach designates somebody else.
32-21 is our score, and at the foul line for the Southview Saints is Latasha Hamilton.
Nice stroke.
She pulls the Lady Saints to within 10, 32-22, 5:42 remaining in the ball game. We'll be picking our Palace Civic Center Movie Move Player of the Game at the conclusion of this freshman game. And a jump ball called. Possession arrow belonging to Admiral King.
You know, Ron, in this game we're seeing, we've had a lot of jump balls. And remember when each one of those was a jump ball? This is one of the reasons for the possession arrow. Could you imagine, you know, if we were jumping each one of these?
The games would seem like forever and a day. Another three-pointer by Sherelle Lucky, but she missed on that one.
Look.
Long pass intercepted by Lucky. She couldn't hang on to it. Going out of bounds, Southview will keep possession.
Okay, here's one of those out of bounds situations where people aren't picking up, and there's a clear shot.
In and out on a shot by Sharday Thorpe. And we have a foul underneath the basket. Foul is going to be on, I do believe, Sierra Sanchez, if I read the referee correctly. That is the fourth team foul for the Lady Saints. The Lady Admirals with seven. Almost a takeaway, but Alicia Williams able to save it. And right into the hands of Marissa Elliott.
Okay. Don't jump and pass.
Sanchez on the rim, gets her own rebound, drops it in for two. Sanchez now in double figures with 10 points.
Okay, now Dominique, okay.
Three-pointer by Sherelle Lucky, no good.
Oh.
Rebound and put in Monica Cortez.
Wow.
6 points for Monica here in the fourth and final quarter. 34-24, Lady Admirals by 10.
Okay, that was an infraction that didn't get called, but that's okay. Oh.
Shot missed, put up by Lisa Friend. And a timeout being called by Admiral King, 34-24. And a reminder, the Palace Civic Center, 6th and Broadway, downtown Lorain, is showing the weekend of Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, February 6th, 7th, and 8th, the movie Peter Pan. Showtime all three nights, 7 p.m. Admission is $3 for adults, $2 for children 12 and under. Peter Pan is the classic fairy tale about the little kids who just didn't want to seem to grow up. And Peter Pan and Tinkerbell and Captain Hook and the crocodile, you'll see them all, but not in cartoon fashion. This is a regular movie with real live human beings. It's the first one ever produced by Hollywood that has not been either a stage production or a cartoon. And you'll be able to see it at the Palace Civic Center, 6th and Broadway, downtown Lorain, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, February 6th, 7th, and 8th. We're going to be telling you about the movie the following weekend. That's a good one, too. Mona Lisa Smile. Loose ball. No one's got it now. Finally, Southview picks it up to the basket. And dropping in two is Marissa Elliott, who gets her first 2 points of the ball game. 34-26, 8-point advantage now by the Lady Admirals. And a 3-point shot missed, put up by Dominique Starr.
Okay, 3:22 left, 34-26, 8 points is a lot of points, Dominique. I don't know if that's the right shot given that situation.
Long pass all alone underneath the basket was Demetria Lee, but the pass was beyond her grasp, going out of bounds. King gets it.
You know, within the next minute or so, Lady Saints are going to have to come out of that zone and start picking up and pressing. 8 points in a freshman girls game with 3 minutes left is a lot of points, or are a lot of points. And they're going to have to come out and start to create something off their defense. They have to get after a little bit more.
Underneath the basket, Cortez couldn't get it to drop this time.
Well, that's one of those high on the glass situations.
Got to use that glass.
Yeah, absolutely.
Very
get it
important.
Up high and soft off the glass.
Now, I've talked in the past about watching my granddaughter playing seventh grade basketball in Parma at the middle school. And that's one of the things that they need to try to learn is
absolutely.
Use that backboard. That's why it's there. You have a much better chance of getting that ball to drop in. Possession arrow, the ball will stay with the Lady Saints.
Okay, here we go with one of the out-of-bounds plays. These have been the best scoring opportunities all night.
But right between the legs of Chardae Thorpe.
We're setting a record tonight for jump balls. situations, arrow, possession arrow situations. And I can see now, you know, I haven't always been in favor of it because I think a lot of times the possession arrow doesn't reinforce good defensive play. But this would be a long game if we were jumping each of these. Okay, 5 seconds. Now, late in the game, at any level, you know, when you're up by eight or so and you can't get it in bounds, know your timeout situation and take a timeout and get reorganized.
Long shot attempted by Thorpe. Coming down with the rebound, Latasha Kimbrough into the lane, and it's ripped
nice
from here.
Steal.
Here comes Latasha Hamilton.
Oh.
She is fouled by Dominique Starr. Eight team fouls against the Lady Admirals. Hamilton will go to the line. She'll shoot two as she was fouled in the act of shooting. Hamilton has made a total of 5 points from the foul line tonight.
She has. Very nice stroke, very nice release, follows through, nice backspin, good lift, very nice.
If she makes this one, she'll go into double figures with 10 points. I hope I didn't jinx her. Coming down with the rebound, Alicia Bradford, Dominique Starr,
wow.
And two.
See, Dominique's one of the few gals who can take it at a high rate of speed and finish. I mean, that's well done. I see a nice future for her.
And a 30-second timeout called by Southview with the score 36, Admiral King 27, Southview. Like we mentioned, the movie Mona Lisa Smile will be at the Palace Civic Center, 6th and Broadway, downtown Lorain on Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, February 13th, 14th, and 15th. And again, showtime all three nights, 7 p.m., $3 for adults, $2 for children 12 and under. Mona Lisa Smile is rated PG-13 for sexual content and thematic issues. It runs 117 minutes. If you go to see it at 7, you'll be out by 8:50. 1953 America was a time ripe for change for women, and when Catherine Ann Willis, played by Julia Roberts, arrives to teach art history at Wesley College, she finds the institution drowning in outdated morals, or mores.
That's an over and back call there.
So while the nation struggles with the fears that accompany a shifting political culture, the powers that be at Wesley seem to want to recourse at the women who had been the backbone of the World War II workforce just a few years earlier. Sounds kind of intriguing. That's Mona Lisa Smile at the Palace Civic Center, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, February 13th, 14th, and 15th. And the ball taken away from Dominique. Here comes Hamilton, missing on the two-pointer. Gets her own rebound, back up, misses again. And Dominique and one of the Lady Saints, and that's Hamilton. Another jump ball, possession arrow, will belong to Admiral King. Well, they're saying possession arrow now belongs to the Lady Saints. So they'll put it back into play. They trail by 9 points, 36-27, with a minute and 45 remaining in the ball game. Dominique Starr takes the ball away into the forecourt, into the lane, passes out, and a shot missed by Sherelle Lucky, but it is Randleman putting in two. Long pass going out of bounds, and Southview wants to call a full timeout with the score 38-27. We'll be back to wrap it up right after this timeout.
Your one-stop place for something really special is Impressions, corner of Oberlin Avenue and Tower Boulevard. T-shirts and sweatshirts personally designed to your specific needs. Anything from bears, trains to zebras, and specially designed hats as well. And don't forget Impressions, your one-stop spot for school jackets. See Dave, the designer expert at Impressions, Oberlin Avenue at Tower Boulevard, right here in Lorain.
CC's Buffet has 16 kinds of great-tasting pizza, pasta, salad, and desserts. All you can eat for only $3.99. And CC's was voted number one for overall customer satisfaction.
The best buffet that you can find. Lunch and dinner anytime. Let's go to CC's Pizza. Great taste at a great price.
Hands in her face and still scored.
All right, that's Monica Cortez. Now with 10 points in the ball game and eight of them coming here in the fourth quarter. 40-27, 13-point advantage for the Lady Admirals, and we've got full-scale substitution here.
Yeah. And this
by
just,
Coach Angie Thomas.
Right, and I've been watching Angie, a former student of mine. This just hasn't happened with 104 left. She's been subbing very liberally throughout the entire game, and so has Coach Bergen. And that's what you have to do at the freshman level. You have to have playing time. You have to kind of balance out, well, we're trying to win with playing time, because that's what this is all about. It's a developmental situation.
I was just going to say, Bob, it's nice to win, but right. The most important thing is to get these gals to the point where
exactly.
They understand the game and know how to properly play it.
Right.
Because the emphasis then goes up eventually to the varsity level.
Right.
That's where the winning is important.
Okay, Angie's running in another five. Or her other five. Oh, she's going offense defense here, I think.
Well, we have 49 seconds remaining, and the Lady Admirals with a 13-point advantage. Is it safe to assume that they've pretty much got the game?
Yeah, 13 points is a lot of points. But, you know, Ron, it's a lot of points. We both remember the days that in varsity girls basketball, you'd never get 67 points scored. You know, and the girls' game has just evolved, and the girls are so much better skill level now than they used to be. It's just amazing. And I've said it on prior broadcasts, I enjoy watching NCAA Division I women's basketball more than any other level. That, I think, is the purest game going right now.
Marissa Elliott, by the way, was at the line for the Lady Saints, missing on that first foul shot. She was there shooting 1-1.
Oh, that's two passes away off the ball. They're calling it tight. Oh, what Angie Thomas is doing here, she has an offensive team going in when they have the ball and has a defensive team going in to press when they don't. Get in there.
On the missed shot, Demetria Lee.
Ooh, good pass.
And that's Tasia Myrick missing on the shot and a foul. With 12.8 seconds remaining in the ball game. Aisha Lusain at the line, she'll shoot two. Aisha Lusain with her first point in the ball game. And a chance to make it two.
Oh.
Stepping on the line. Well,
he's
didn't
rough.
Drop in anyway, so 41-27. Lady Admirals lead by 14. Almost an interception on that pass by Latasha Kimbrough.
You know, really one of the differences here has been the team that pressed has scored the most points.
Tasia Myrick and can't quite hang on to the ball. It goes out of bounds.
And I believe we have 4/10 left, Ron.
4/10 of a second.
Impossible to get a shot off, so say the experts.
And that'll do it. Our final score, Lady Admirals victorious over the Lady Saints on the freshman level by a score of 41-27. Bob and I will be back to wrap it up. We'll have the final scoring statistics for you, and we'll have our Palace Civic Center Movie Move Player of the Game right after this timeout.
When your child gets sick with the usual illnesses an unusual number of times, it could be an immune deficiency called PI. Get the warning signs.
One down and two to go here at Lorain Admiral King High School. In the Shot Palace, we've completed the freshman game with the Lady Admirals victorious over the Lady Saints by a score of 41-27. Your thoughts on the game, Bob?
I enjoyed it. I love watching young kids play. I saw good players on both sides. I saw kids that I think have big upsides. We don't want to mention any names, but I saw a lot of good things. And most importantly, the girls had a good time. They enjoyed it.
All right, let's look at the scoring by quarter. At the end of the first 7 minutes, the Lady Admirals had a 3-point advantage, 7-4. In the second quarter, the Lady Admirals put in 15 points, and the Lady Saints 12. The locker room score was 22-16. Then for some reason, in the third quarter, both teams extremely cold, only scoring 3 points each. It was 25-19 at the end of three quarters. And then the Lady Admirals came alive again in the fourth quarter with 16 points, but held the Lady Saints to just 8 for our final 41-27 score. Scoring for the Lady Saints, Felicia Franklin had 1 point. Marissa Elliott had 2. It was Lisa Friend with 2 points. Sharday Thorpe had 3 points. Latasha Hamilton had 9 points. with five of those coming in the fourth quarter. And high for the Lady Saints in double figures, Sierra Sanchez with 10 points. Ironically, eight of those in the first half, Bob, but only 2 points in the second half, and those two coming in the fourth quarter. For the Lady Admirals, it was Alicia Williams with 6 points. Kiara Lagarde had 2 points. Aisha Lusane had 1 point. Latasha Kimbrough scored 4. It was Sherelle Lucky with 5 points. Natasha Randleman had 3. And in double figures for the ladies' admirals, it was Dominique Starr with 10 and Monica Cortez with 10. 8 of those coming in the fourth quarter. She had 2 back in the first quarter. So, again, 41-27, and our Palace Civic Center Movie Move Player of the Game for the Lady Admirals of Lorain Admiral King High School, number 14, Dominique Starr. And your comments on Dominique?
Well, not only did she score 10, but she created situations for other people to score, and that's why we chose her as our Movie Player of the Game.
And as we indicated, too, she, along with Natasha Randleman, a very tall 5'8" freshman, have been added to Coach Pam Jackson's varsity list come tournament time when the Lady Admirals will go to play the tournaments at Westlake High School. Well, that wraps it up on the freshman game.
This has been a production of Lorain City Schools TV20 WLCS.
To purchase a high-quality copy of the program you just viewed, please call Lorain City Schools Television at 282-8400.